Hello, my wonderful Sagittarius. I hope you all are doing amazing. In today's video, I will be tapping into the energies of your love life. So it's going to be your general love reading for the week here. So pretty much whatever comes out for you guys. Okay. Okay, guys, so we have the card decision. It's time to decide about this relationship. Okay. So obviously there could be, you know, like it says, a decision at hand here. Okay. Or maybe you have been going back and forth in your mind, whether it's about moving things to the next level, whether it's about needing to release this person. But there is definitely some sort of indecisive behavior at hand. This could obviously be your person's energy that I'm picking up on, but let's see. Okay, so we have the Eight of Cups on the bottom of the deck. Split the deck and we have the Devil. Okay. So this is someone that you have emotionally, you're trying to emotionally detach from them, but it could be someone that you've walked away from because you felt that there was something that felt very unhealthy, potentially even toxic about the bond here. For some of you, this could be a water sign that you're involved with, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, or it could be a Capricorn. But what I see here, guys, is your person is definitely thinking about you, okay? The Devil could be letting me know there's a lot of obsessive thoughts. They may feel like, you know, thinking about the situation makes them feel like they're on a hamster wheel and they can't get off of it. But with the Eight of Cups here, I will say, guys, like, it's someone who feels like they have a lot of chemistry with you. They can't stop thinking of you. They still feel very attached to you, but there may be something that's causing a blockage here. So let's see if these cards come out again. For many of you, maybe you do feel connected to this person. You do feel like there's a lot of attraction, but you may feel like there's a decision that needs to be made. Maybe you feel like this is someone that you feel the chemistry with. This is someone that feels very familiar to you, but you may want more when it comes to this connection. Okay. Six of Swords. You want a peace of mind right now. That's what you're trying to attain here. Now, the Six of Swords could also be letting me know that you're quite literally moving away from the situation, as in like relocating. But it could also be, you know, moving away from something on like, you know, a mental level here. You're wanting a peace of mind because you're feeling very exhausted. We have the Three of Swords on the bottom of the deck, the Wheel of Fortune, and the Queen of Cups. So here's what I see. More than anything, you feel very emotionally drained. You may feel like you do want a change in this dynamic, but up until now, you do feel like, you know, there has been a lot of back and forth. There's a lot that you have gone through with this person, but it has yet to result in your desired outcome. So it's almost like you feel you were constantly either, you know, putting your best foot forward or speaking to this person and creating a safe space so that they can open up to you emotionally. But you feel like your efforts were not being acknowledged, or you feel like you put forth a lot of effort and now you're looking at it like, okay, I wasted my time and effort because, again, the outcome is not my desired outcome here. Main thing I'm getting is your person could be viewing you as very emotionally drained when it comes to this situation. Okay, and with the Six of Swords, that is moving away, moving to calmer waters. Eight of Pentacles. This person may feel like you have shifted your focus towards work. Okay, finances, that sort of thing. The World, the Empress, the King of Wands, the High Priestess, Ten of Cups. Okay. So Sagittarius, not only do I feel like the change that took place between the both of you is affecting this person, they still have their eyes on you. They still see a lot of potential in this bond here. And this is what they're keeping to their self. I feel like for some of you, this is an individual who failed to make a choice in the past, but they still feel connected to you, but they feel they don't have a right to say that to you, or it's going to come off as maybe, you know, not being the brightest, you know, bulb here. Like they don't feel like it would be the brightest idea to express to you how they feel because they were not doing that in the past. So they are keeping their emotions under wraps here, but they're very focused on you. For some of you, they may even feel like you're doing better, you know, off without them. And for others of you, you may have children with this person. So there could have been a separation and this could be someone who is wanting to return home or return to their family. Let's see. Nine of Pentacles, wow. Yeah, some of you are very successful. You're being viewed in a very abundant energy. For others of you, you may actually feel like this connection here has really drained you, where now that you're shifting, you know, the focus to yourself and your career, things are working out for you. So you are feeling, you know, positive. You are feeling a lot more stable. For some of you, you may feel like this connection actually affected your stability. Whether that was because you feel the, you know, the finances were one-ended or one-sided here. Maybe you feel like you were kind of working really hard to keep the relationship going. Or maybe you just feel like you were putting your desires and your goals on the back burner because you were overextending yourself in this connection. But there's something about you feeling more stable now than when you were in this connection here. Bottom of the deck, we have the Six of Pentacles, the Seven of Pentacles, and the King of Cups. Yeah. This person really does have a lot of emotions for you, but I see them kind of observing how they could have been more open or how they could have put more practical effort in this connection. So when this person observes this connection or when they think of you, they're thinking about what like what they could have done more of is essentially what I'm getting. Like, okay, I could have, you know, reached out to Sagittarius more, or maybe I could have, they're thinking about like the effort and their lack of effort, because now that they want to give to this situation or they're feeling generous, they're like, okay, well, looking at the past, I could have done more. I should have done more. That kind of energy. Page of Pentacles. Okay, bottom of the deck here, the Devil again, the Five of Wands and the Ace of Cups. Wow. Okay. So that not only does this person want to, you know, reach out to you, you could be speaking to this person, you know, right now as you're watching my read here, but with the Ace of Cups, as much as they want a new beginning here, Devil and the Five of Wands, they're having conflicting, you know, opinions. This could be conflicting opinions like in their, you know, direct circle, like their friends or like direct family, but they are feeling very restricted. This may even be someone who is trying to close out some sort of drama before they come forward towards you because they don't want to project that onto the bond here. But we're seeing the Devil for the second time here. So it is definitely someone who feels restricted, or they feel like their options right now are very limited. So what is the Six of Swords? Two of Pentacles. It's like they sense you moving away, but they're like, what do I do? This may even be someone who feels like they have a lot on their plate right now, whether it's because they have, you know, responsibilities such as maybe more than one job, or they have, you know, children, or whatever it is. They feel like they have a lot on their plate, but you're still on their mind. It's just they feel very restricted when it comes to their next actions. And I feel like the restrictions are coming from a space of like something that's going on in their external environment or something that they feel entitled to. Bottom of the deck here, we have the Six of Wands, the Queen of Cups, and the Chariot. This person wants your attention. More so, they want your emotional like attention. Like they want you to, you know, either nurture them, or they want you to tell them that everything is going to be okay. But it lets me know that you're not really operating from a space of emotions, because this is essentially what they're craving from you. Okay, what is the Eight of Pentacles? Two of Cups. Bottom of the deck, what is it? Seven of Wands, Knight of Wands. Yeah, the Star. It's like they know what they share with you is very special. You may know this as well, Sagittarius. And with the Two of Cups, that could speak about mutual, you know, emotions. But what I see with the Seven of Wands and the Knight of Wands is not only may, like this person could have been, you know, very inconsistent with you, but with the Seven of Wands, there's something about them being very defensive when it comes to their past actions. So as much as they realize that a connection that they share with you is very special, or they're wanting more here, there's something that they're not ready to address. And it could be their behavior in the past here. And with the Seven of Wands, this could be someone like you may feel like even if you are trying to have a conversation to tell them what to work on or what the both of you could work on, you feel like they resort to like a very defensive energy. Or even if you're not trying to offend them, by default, you do feel like this person gets offended because of some sort of insecurities that are, you know, deeply rooted within them. So like for many of you, even if you want to just converse with this person, you feel like it's like going to turn into an argument. It's going to escalate because this person has some sort of insecurities that they're not dealing with. What is the Nine of Pentacles? The Tower. Bottom of the deck here, the Knight of Cups, the Queen of Pentacles, Ten of Swords. They want to apologize to you, I will say that, but they also feel like Like you choosing to be on your own, or like something working out for you while you're in a period of solitude was very abrupt. So it's like, even if there was a separation, they feel like, you know, you're handling the separation much better than they are, but like this is almost like so unexpected for them. So I wonder if they expected you to reach out, or they expected, you know, you guys to like reconcile here, come together. But I feel like the fact that a separation remained a separation could be very unexpected for this person. Now, with the Knight of Cups and the Queen of Pentacles, they are wanting to apologize to you. I will say that, because with the Ten of Swords, they're very focused on, you know, some sort of betrayal. But the Ten of Swords could also be read as like disrespect. So like, you know, this person could have disrespected you, but they are, you know, dealing with the hurt, the sorrow here. What is the Page of Pentacles? The Five of Wands. Yeah. It's like they're trying to close out a cycle, or they're trying to deal with some sort of conflict in their external environment before they approach you. For others of you, when they look at the bond with you, they do feel like there's a lot that they could have avoided. Like the Five of Wands, guys, it could be like petty conflict or just like bickering that could escalate into something larger when you, and then when you look back at the situation, you're like, wow, we got into such a large argument, but it stemmed from such a small issue where it did not have to escalate, or things did not have to be blown out of proportion here. So I do feel like there's a lot of regret for paying attention to things of such little importance. You understand what I'm saying, Sagittarius? Like they may feel like there are arguments that they could have avoided. Maybe they feel like there were times that they were being very petty, or there were times that they were trying to get under your skin. And they're looking at it like, was it really worth it? You know, they could even be looking at it like, okay, well, I wanted the last word in an argument, but was it really worth it? Because Sagittarius and I are not speaking anymore. Devil again on the bottom of the deck, the Three of Pentacles, the Three of Wands. They're stuck on you. They are obsessively thinking about you because they want to work together. Three of Pentacles. Three of Wands is someone who's focused on the future, guys. It's someone who's like making a plan. They're like, I want to come together. I want to come to a mutual understanding, but there's still a blockage in the way, which for many of you, I feel like is this person wanting to work with you, but not wanting to address what happened in the past here. Not wanting to address, you know, potentially why you walked away. What is the Two of Pentacles? Queen of Swords, yeah. It's like they feel like you're very upset with them. I will say that. They, and more than upset, I think that there's an energy of you feeling very like fed up, or like very drained. Like you don't have the energy to, you know, continue or to try again here. Knight of Cups, Queen of Pentacles, and Ten of Swords. Main thing I see here is this person's very apologetic because they're feeling very connected to you. But if they like they want to reach out to you, but this may be someone who wants some sort of a reaction, or they feel like a conflict will occur if they were to, you know, say what's on their mind here. It doesn't mean it's the truth. This is just what's going on in their mind. And I will say with the Queen of Swords, Two of Pentacles, and Six of Swords, something that you made very clear is you're not going to be an option. You're not going to wait around for this person to make a decision. It doesn't have to be that it was a decision between two people, but you could have still felt strung along because maybe you felt that if we share this connection here, why aren't you putting forth more effort? Why aren't you working on it? Why aren't you working on moving things to the next level? It's like you really wanted this person to make a decision, and maybe you have been giving this person the benefit of the doubt, but your first card is it's time to decide about this relationship. So maybe you guys are in between worlds where you're like, okay, I'm really tired, or you know, I'm getting to a point where I'm completely you know, drained, and I want to make a decision in terms of, you know, do I completely move over and move on and let this person, you know, let this person go, or do I give this person another chance? Like, obviously, for some of you, you may want to speak to this person, excuse me, but what I see here is you're wanting a solution. You either feel very strung along, or as much as you feel the connection, you're wanting something more from it, and you're not going to settle for just feeling connected to someone but not being in a, you know, full-blown commitment here. It's almost like as much as you feel connected to this person, you feel like you know what you want, but this person does not. What is the Two of Cups? Page of Cups. Bottom of the deck, the Three of Wands, yeah. Like it's someone who has emotions for you, but we see the Page of Pentacles and the Page of Cups. Like they're showing up as a page, which means they could be handling something in an immature manner. You could be viewing them in an unpredictable energy. It's like even if this person tells you the right things, today, you don't know what to expect tomorrow. You don't know if they're just saying things in the spur of the moment. You're wanting more maturity, more specifically emotional maturity from this person. Yeah, they want to work on things with you, Sagittarius. Yeah, they have emotions for you, but they're approaching it in such a lighthearted manner, which for many of you could come off as not enough, because you seem to be fed up with either immature behavior, petty conflicts, or something in this person's environment that is making them feel restricted. Because for some of you, even if you know that this person is in, you know, for example, like a drama-filled environment, you're like, why are you not taking the initiative to change that? Okay, what is the Tower? Eight of Swords, yeah. Very stuck in their head. That's what I see. And Eight of Swords is also a card of restrictions because of what you're feeding yourself in your mind, because of what you're telling yourself. And with the Nine of Pentacles and the Tower, I do feel like they did not expect you to be on your own, or they did not expect for the both of you to remain, you know, silent with each other. Like, this may be someone that you've given countless, you know, chances to, or you feel like you guys always find your way back to each other, or there's always an energy of being forgiving where you may be, you know, getting very serious with yourself. You are being, it's like you're trying to make a very firm decision here. You're no longer wanting to just go with the flow, or you know, be in this connection aimlessly. Like, you have a goal, you know what you want, but if you feel like this person does not, maybe you feel you're also very tired of feeling stuck. Because it's not to say you don't have emotions, but there's a lack of progress here when it comes to the changes that you want to see. That's what I'm getting at. Five of Wands. Four of Swords, yeah. I feel like this person's viewing you as someone who is keeping to yourself, someone who is healing. And, you know, even in the future outcome with the Page of Pentacles, the Five of Wands, and the Four of Swords, this is someone who knows you're healing, but they want some sort of a reaction from you. Or they're hoping that if they reach out to you, you actually respond. But look at it this way, Sagittarius. If you're just wanting this person to reach out, of course, that would be your desired outcome, and that'd be great. But with the Page of Pentacles and the Page of Cups, if you're wanting this person to, you know, move this connection to the next level or be more mature about it, they're still showing up as a page. So for many of you, you're not really wanting to play any sort of mind games. You're not really wanting to give this person the reaction that they want. It's not to say this is not an open-minded individual or someone who's not willing to learn, but I just feel like their approach here seems like it's not enough on your end. And I'm not saying that you're entitled in any way, but it seems that you know what you want here, or you feel stable on your own, but you feel like this is someone who is not that confident, you know, on their own, or this is someone who still has some sort of figuring out to do, where now you're looking out for yourself. You're like, yeah, I feel connected to you, but if you're going to bring me down, or, you know, you're not going to be able to offer me stability, I don't know if I want to be involved here. And on your person's end, I do feel like they want to speak to you, but there's a lack of decision here, guys, because there's a Two of Pentacles, so they may be in between worlds. Okay. So, my wonderful Sagittarius, that is what I'm getting for you this week. I really do hope you were able to find a message that resonated with you here today. And thank you so much for your time.